everybody, this is Els from Elizabeth Craft Designs. Welcome to the Mega Make and Take event, the virtual one. So we are going to make this pop-up card, the shell pop-up card from the Under the Sea collection from Elizabeth Craft Designs, designed by Josette. So it's a little bit different because normally we have like everybody in the room and it's taking a bit longer, of course, to explain everything. So now I can do it all to you direct. So what I did is, so you have the kits, and what I did as well, I prepared one that I did some shading on. So if you want to get some ink out, you can do that. And if you want to do it exactly as it is on the paper, you can do that as well. But we have enough time, so grab your ink if you want to. And what I have here, the ones I use are these. So spiced marmalade, peeled paint, white honey, and scattered straw. But honestly, it can be any like orangey, green, a little sand tone or something for the shell. So it doesn't need to be those colors. Like just to edge the like the crab a little bit, you see here on the edges, and the shell a little bit. So if you want to do that, you can grab that. And we have time enough, so I'm going to leave you a minute to grab that if you want to. And so we're going to work on this cute card. It's absolutely adorable. So this is from the Under the Sea collection, and the dies we use for this one is the shell one. That is this. So that's the pop-up, and it comes with this one in there that we kind of put inside. So that's this part, and you can make that into a pop-up. But if you want to make it like a puddle of sand somewhere, you can do that as well. And I have another sample that I will show you in the second part after the make and take. That is adorable to work with as well. And this is the pearl that comes with it. And then we have the crab. So that's this one. So this is the crab. Comes with his little house here and then the eyes. But we're going to use googly eyes now. But the die set comes with the eyes as well. And then we use the seaweed here and the anchor from this set here. So, and that is all. You can find all those dies in the catalog. And that catalog you can get for free when you order something. And let me not forget to tell you that the discount code for this event is EXPO20. And EXPO20 will give you 20% discount on anything you buy. Also from the sales item, but this is the Under the Sea collection that we're working with right now. And this catalog is available online and you can click on it and then you get one for free. Because normally we hand those out to you at Expo, but since we're not there, you can get it for free online. So that's the Under the Sea collection. Okay, so let's get started. So if you got your ink, you are ready to go. Let me put the die away. So what I have here, so we're going to make this one. And I'm kind of going to work on two at the same time so you see the results for both of them. So this is the pop-up part. You see? The card, sorry. That's the shell card. Then you have your pop-up piece. So what you're going to do with your pop-up piece, you're going to fold it backwards first. So fold it like this. And then you fold it open and then basically that part pops up right away. If it doesn't do that, you kind of give it a little push here in the back. So fold it backwards, fold it back, and then it goes like this. And then you kind of squeeze it here tightly. That is nice and sharp, a sharp folding line. So that's that. And I have that for the shaded one as well. And if you want to shade this, and of course, if you decide to kind of, you want to do the shaded, you can just watch and then put it together after this part, of course, because I assume this will all stay for a little bit. Then we're going to take our double-sided adhesive. And we're going to put it on the back of this part, but make sure you don't put it on that pop-up part. Because that pop-up part needs to stay free, of course, because if you put your glue here or your adhesive, it will stick to the card and it's not a pop-up anymore. So we're going to put the double-sided adhesive on the back here. And again, if you think I want to make more and you buy the die, you can do the regular one now and then you can do a shaded one later. And I will give you more ideas with the die set after we have done the make and take. And I hope, because sometimes when it's at the expo itself, of course, it's loud. So Right now, you can actually all hear me. And then we, myself with my weird accents, sometimes people have trouble understanding what I say, which is normal, I think, in my case, because it's a, I know I don't say everything perfect, but now it's more visual for everybody. So that's actually a big advantage to this event, I think. So, so we have that pop-up part now. Then make sure that you have, because that shell has an embossed part. That will be your top, your front, and then the flat part will be on the back. So make sure this is showing on the front. Then you open it. Then we take off all the pieces of tape, or if you do a wet glue, you just do that, of course. This is our clear double-sided adhesive from Elizabeth Craft Designs. And now we get an important part, and I will do the same with the other one. We get an important part because we are going to hold this like this, you see, and then we're going to kind of put it together. Then you put it exactly in the folds here, and then close the card, and then you have the perfect pop-up here. So I will repeat that because that you can see that again. Let me take this one. There we go. And then we can start putting the card together. And it's a super fun one. Of course, I have the crab here, but you can do that with all the different characters from this line. So here I have this one. And again, fold it. And it doesn't matter which part you have on the top of the bottom. That doesn't matter. So fold it, hold it, put it in the fold of the card here. And then close your card, you see, and then you have your pop-up piece. So make sure that you have the embossed parts on the front, because that's important, because that's how it needs to look. Alrighty, so here we have that one. Now we're going to build it. So what you have your crab here with his two claws. You have some seaweed, you have the red seaweed, we have his little house here. We have the mouth, and I think with most of them, I was going to add double-sided adhesive on the back of the mouth, and we forgot. So I think most of you will have it without the adhesive on the back. So, and then you have your googly eyes. And I have two pairs here, and I will build this one now, and I will build the other one later, so you can see that. If I have time, I will build the shaded one as well, but let me focus on this one now. So here you have your crab. Then you're going to take those googly eyes. Those have adhesive on the back, so you can either do it with your nails. I kind of pop in here with my tweezer a little bit, and then you lift up that adhesive, but you can also take it off with your nails. Then you're going to put it, because this crab will, it has embossed lines, you see, so it has embossed lines where to put the mouth and where to put the eyes. So I take my googly eye and I stick it on there. And I see I'm off a little bit, but then I can slide it loose again. There we go. That's kind of an advantage now because I have a daylight lamp, so I can kind of see. So for this one, I'm going to do the same. And I'm using our fine pointed tweezers here, and most of you are familiar with that. And now I need to see that embossed line. It's here. You see, so now I have the eyes on. Oh, with this one I have the eyes on already, I see. And I did this mouth already as well. So then I'm taking a little bit of our Kids' Choice glue. I'm putting that on my finger. And then I'm taking that mouth, and I'm taking my tweezer. Just tip it in here at the end a bit, get rid of that glue, and then I put it where, oh, a little bit too much glue, make sure it's not too much glue, just a tiny bit, you don't want to squeeze out that glue there. And then I have my crab here, you see, and I can probably work on both at the same time, because I think we're good on time, and it gives you some time if you do the edging as well. To work on that, you see. So now we have the crab here, and then we have that pop-up piece. So now I'm going to put the claws behind the crab, and they're going to be like here, so sticking out of the body sides. So what I did is I took some tape, and you're going to put that where the arms will be, because that will, then I can just stick them behind there. You see, like that. I do the same with this one. So kind of where that body starts, because then you can just stick those claws behind that part. So doing this, then you take this one, kind of just attach it to the, and you can of course make him, you know, move the arms so where you want them to be, or the claws. You can put them wider here. You can put them wider. You can put them closer. That's wherever you want, how you want that to look. So that's that one. And I'm going to do the same with this one. So put the claw behind it. And then with this one, you see, so this one I etched a little bit with the ink. There we go. You see, so it just gives it a little bit of extras. And normally, of course, because, you know, I cannot hand out all those inks at the expo. And now I thought it would be kind of cool to show you different options. And this is the first time, so maybe we do things differently next time, because I could have told you to get ink before, but you know, I kind of came up with that idea as we go. So this again, with the mouth, there are pieces I know that are without tape and with tape. So if you don't have tape on the back, I'm sorry about that. Just stick it on there with glue or adhesive, because that's something we did wrong with the first kits, but then they were already ready. So stick this on here, and then with this one, I'm just going to put a piece of tape on there. Or you can do some glue, of course. Stick that on there. And by adding the ink, it gives it a little bit more depth. So that can be nice. But, and then again, the crepe will be in front of that. Then I'm going to place this one. And when you're going to place the shell, like the little house on here, you put your tape on that popper piece. Don't put it on here, because again, if that glue sticks out, If you close your card, it will get stuck. So make sure you take tape or glue and put it on that popper piece. It's probably easier to just trim a piece. Makes it easier to put it on there. And don't put it all the way at the bottom. I need to say that as well. Don't put it all the way down, because you see, it doesn't go, like the shell has a round edge there, so it doesn't stick all the way to the bottom. So make sure you don't put it all the way to the bottom. And I hope you're all doing well. And normally I would say, do you have any questions? But, you know, we are doing this live, so we're going as we go. Okay, so now I take this off, so double-sided adhesive, take off the release sheet, and you place your shell on there. And then you close it and kind of press it. So we'll do the same with this one. You see, put it on here, and then press it. So that's that. You see, so now I have both my cards. Then I'm going to add the crepe, and I do that by adding an extra piece of tape, because that one piece is not enough, and the claws kind of raise a little bit on the back, so you want to make sure that it got stuck well. Don't put it all the way to the top, because you can see his head sticks out a little bit. So I'm going to put it on the body, but not all the way to the top. So if you have a wet glue, don't put it all the way to the top. That's... and here, so that's that one. And I'm going to put this on there, and almost like his feet will touch the ground, but not completely. And with ink, when you inked it, it might be that it doesn't stick that well right away, because sometimes inks need to dry. And you do the same, and you close it again. Yeah, and when you do the ink, don't press it too hard, because your ink might still show then on your shell. Just think about that. So we're all learning here. So it's the first time for us as well to do that virtual event. So I hope it all works out for you. And of course, we're all anxious to know if it did, you see? So that's that one, you see? And it stands up perfectly. So now we have the Wishing You Oceans of Joy. And that's from the stamp set. That also comes, let me show you that. That also comes with the with that same collection. So this one, so we're using the seaweed here. We're using the sand crab. And then we are using the Splish Splash Sentiments there as well. And then the oyster shell card. And that label I have here is actually from a Planner Essential. So I thought it looked cool. But the lady that actually cut all the kits says, Else, can you pick another one next time? Because it was fiddly to get all those pieces out. So another one next time, she said, please. So putting some 3D foam here. And then I'm sticking it on there. And of course, if you want to, you can put a piece of twine through it later, because that's kind of cool. And that's all things, of course, that come up later that you think, oh, that would have been cool. So stick this here and this one here. And I have a piece of twine with me. Let me show you that quickly. Where is it? So for instance, oh yeah, this one, sorry. You see, if you have something like this and you kind of do that wiggly woggly over there, that would be cool to see, I think. But that's an idea. So then we have the anchors. So what you do with that, you can either put a little piece of tape there, or you take a little bit of glue, but only a little bit, because you don't want to make that it shows on your silver cardstock. So just a little tip, and I only do it at the top. And that's enough, because I lay that kind of here over that label a little bit, and then just press it down at the top. The same with this one, just a little bit of glue, and then press that down at the top. So that's that one. And now we have the seaweed left, and you see here again, I etched it a little bit. And for that seaweed, I'm only going to put some glue at the bottom of the seaweed, because that seaweed, of course, you want to have that a little bit like you know, moving. So you take a little bit of glue, put it on there, and then just stick it. And this one I kind of stick on the pop-up, because then it pops up above that crab here. Same with this one, you see that one. And then we have the other three pieces. Oh, that's on the front, one on the back. And that's, I say that's on the front, because when you die cut, it kind of rounds the corner. So that's why I can always clearly see what's the front and the back. And I really like that, took some glue off. I really like that rounded edge. And that's what you always see with die, especially when it has embossed line on it, like the crab itself and the card. So I'm just tipping this in the glue here, putting this here, you see, and kind of you can move it a bit. So only put some glue at the bottom, so at the top you kind of see some movement, which I like in this case. So that's that one. How cool are these? Isn't that super cool? And I will show you some samples when we're done, because there are the most amazing samples. Of course, you can find it on social media as well. But on, yeah, all the cards are on our Facebook page and on our Instagram. And so Elizabeth Craft Designs. And for this card, for all the parts we used and everything on our website, will be 20% off till the end of the month using code EXPO20. There we go. So that's it. So those are the two cards. So now I have, so you see when you cut those pieces, that it's actually not that much work to make. So this will be great invitations, of course. So they're super fun. Look at those. And then I want to show you some samples. And with the extra time we have here for the for this event, I'm going to work with the same dies from the same collection, and showing you a fun mini book to make as well. So super fun to do. So let me show you a few cards that we created using that same collection, just to give you some inspiration here. So I'm going to put that aside. So again, the inks I used is the Spiced Marmalade, Peeled Paint, Wild Honey, and Scattered Straw. But it could be, in this case, it could be any ink or any, you know, any brands. So you just etch it a little bit like this. And see, that's what you do. Yeah, so that's basically what I did. So it's super easy. So, and let me show you some samples that are created with the same collection. And then later on, I will use all kind of things that use this collection as well. So this is the same one. And then without the red piece, and I made it in glitter. So in our silk microfine glitter. So I cut the same crepe out of cardstock with double-sided adhesive at the front. And then in this case, I used orange cardstock because I like it when I know for sure something is going to be orange. In this case, I choose orange cardstock because then you don't see white edges. So if you want to do it in glitter, you get this effect. Oh, this looks super fun. I will take a picture and post it later on our Facebook group so that you can kind of see what we did here. So that's that one. Then with the same oyster, we did this one. So that is with the mermaids. And here you see the pearl. That's from the seaweed dye as well. You see, how cool is that? And here we just have a rectangle label. You see, so that is with the same oyster dye. Then we have this one. I'll tell you, these ones I had on the board. So they kind of fall over because I had them on the expo board. So I had to kind of have a system to close them as well, keep them closed. So it's a little bit different. And this one is fun to show. You see, that's a beautiful one as well. And it has a little sand crab here. And what we did with this one, you can see there's pattern paper here. So if you die cut that same die, so this one, and we will talk about it in the next segment as well, you can cut this one, trim it in half, and then put it on the card. You want to trim it in half because if you fold it over around the whole card, the decorated paper, it will not fit. So you want to make sure that you have it there cut. And then here I have some more samples, you see. So that's all with the same collection. I think your swale, this one. So there's lots and lots of samples. This was actually the one I was going to do at the Creativity Center with Lorraine. So that's the little turtle with glitter. And then this is the whale again, I think your swale. So super fun. This is the little mermaid. And then I made this one as well. So that's with the same sand crab, but I made a spinner and a slider card. How cool is that? And you see here, I did a little bit piece of twine as well. So this is the spinners and the sliders. And so same sand crab. And let me get the card back into the view here. So this is the card we created. And then this is the same, like the same crab, but as a slider. So this is it for my mega make and take. And then I'm going to show you some other fun things that we create with the same series. So again, for you all, I hope you enjoyed it. And the code is EXPO20 for 20% discount on the full collection. And can't wait to show you the rest. Thank you.